In general, aggregation is the compilation of data to create reports which help in analysis and decision making. The concept of aggregation has reshaped the world over the last decade. How many times you have navigated a website by Googling it? That's the power of aggregation. Based on the level of aggregation, a dataset can be classified as factoid, series, multiseries, summable multiseries, summary records, and individual transactions. Let's start with the individual transaction first. This is a raw sales transaction record with order ID, customer, product, and cost details. There is no aggregation in this data. We can run a detailed analysis with this type of dataset. The next one is the summary records. In this, there is one record for each item in the series. All the transactions of a customer are aggregated in a summary record. Somehow, metrics in this other series also aggregated. The items in the summary record can be compared, and a certain level of deep analysis can also be performed. Now comes the summable multiseries. This has several matrices and a common axis. The summation of the matrices provide the grand total. We can compare rate of change, correlation between matrices, and can compare percentages with the summable multi-series dataset. The next one is the multi-series. A multi-series data are simply several series on one chart or table. We can show them together, but we can't meaningfully stack or combine them. And then series. Series dataset is where one type of dependent variable is compared to an independent variable. Often, the independent variable is time. We can compare just the rate of change with this level of dataset. Finally, factoid. A factoid is a single piece of information that emphasizes a particular point of view or detail. A factoid does not allow for any further statistical analysis. A factoid is calculated from source data. If we get factoid data, there is no further drill down possible. It's recommended to get individual transaction data as it maximizes option to explore. We got a question now to improve the profit in 2022. Let's use Tableau to analyze the data and provide meaningful recommendations. Before we open Tableau, remember we talked about qualitative, quantitative, discrete, and continuous data types in our previous video. In Tableau, dimensions data field contains qualitative values. You can use dimensions to categorize, segment, and reveal the details in your data. Measure data field contains numeric values. Measures can be aggregated. Blue color indicates that the field is treated as a discrete field. Green color indicates that the field is treated as continuous field. And Tableau has a list of predefined aggregation functions. This table is an extract from Tableau website. We will cover few of them in this demonstration. Let's open Tableau. We are going to use a synthetic e-commerce transaction dataset for this demo. Connect to OneStore Excel file. Drag orders table here. This is an individual transaction dataset. We are going to first aggregate the dataset to understand the background of the factoid statement in detail. And then analyze the data to find a way to improve the profit. Click Sheet 1 to open a new sheet. Drag Order
Date to columns field, profit field in the rows field. You might have noticed there are several things happening in Tableau by default. The order dates aggregated to years, profit aggregated to the sum of all profits, and a plot is generated. Double click sheet 1 and change it to profit item. You can change the plot by clicking the option under the show me button. See, $504K profit in 2021. Now we know how the factoid information has been generated from the source data. Now let's analyze the data to find what changes can be done to improve the profit in 2022. Let's open a new sheet. Our strategy is look at the segment in detail to see which one has less profit and focus on them to improve the overall profit. Let us drag order date to column, profit to row, and then category to row field. Select table under show me options. The takeaway here is furniture category is the least contributor to the overall profit. Now, looking at the customer segment, home office is the least contributor to the overall profit. Now, let us add category and subcategory to see which segment is the least contributor. It is clear that the table segment is causing $30K damage to the bottom line. Hence, our preliminary recommendation is to discontinue the table business to improve the profit next year. But the follow-up question from the board is the table business bringing more customer base? They will keep asking until they get the relevant information. Thank you. Please feel free to ask your questions in the comment section. Let's learn together. Learning is fun.